Hey guys, this is SNM Comics. How are you guys doing? I'm going to do a huge haul today. It's gonna be long, so bear with me guys. I got some stories to tell you. I got some really sweet books to show you, so hang on to your chairs. Don't get too blown away, alright? Alright, so tonight I was able to see the master at work today, the TheDoom143. He called me, he's saying that he was at the Collectors Expo that was happening at the Neo Blazer Center here in Hawaii. And as soon as I got off work, I end up meeting up with him, which he was already there. He already hit a couple of vendors. And the books that he showed me, man, it's just phenomenal. He got such a great stealth buy. And I was fortunate to see this guy, the Doom. Hunt, go through these long and short boxes, and his fingers, like, I don't know, he's just going through each book, and man, it was just very fun to watch him work. And of course I had my own little time hunting and, you know, finding good books as well. So I'm going to show you what I picked up at the Collectors Expo, and also some few eBay purchases, and my LCS new comic book that came out this week, also with some back issues as well. And towards the end, I got myself another key issue book, so hold on to your seat. Alright, before I start, I want to do some shout out to some new YouTuber. So get your paper and pencil ready and write it down. If not, I'll provide their link to their channel at the bottom of this video in the descriptions, all right? So first shout out will be SPT KILLERWOOD. Man, this guy is just killing it with his Spawn runs and, you know, the new comic that he's been getting. It's just phenomenal. The rate that he's going, he's probably gonna finish the Spawn run by next week, if anything, man. But yeah, go check him out, sub him out, man. You won't regret it. Second shout out will be QB Comic Addict. QB as an abbreviation as quarterback, all right? Comic Addict. QB Comic Addict. That guy, man. Oh, Jesus. What can I say about this guy? I mean, he probably will have like a little over 50 subs, but he should be, man, the books that he's been showing, Jesus Christ, the last videos that I remember that he just uploaded was, he showed NYX number 39.8 CGC, and also he got that Adam Hughes, his Holy Grail, Supergirl, Legion of blah 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 blah. I really don't know, that's a long ass title, but it's a Supergirl, one of the rarest Adam Hughes cover you can find, alright? And also, the last is Chase Variant. His channel says it all. He's all about chasing variant. He shows like hard to find variants, you know, in store incentive variants. I mean, you name it, he got it. If he doesn't, he's gonna chase it down and he's gonna show it in his next video. These three channels, man, go sub them out because, man, they're just killing it. You know, show some support, sub them out, why not? You won't regret it. I really enjoy watching their video day in, day out. Every time when they upload it, man, I really enjoy them. So, you know, go check them out, all right? So, I told you I met up with Doom143. As soon as I got there, like he said, hey man, I got yourself a book already. So, I said, what you got me, man? He said, boom, right there, Ultimate Fallout, one out of 25, Jerkovic variant. This is a connecting variant that has a 7 issues. I already got number 5, I got number 6, and this is number 3. Number 4 is the one that you should be getting in this connecting, because that sucker has like cost at least about $300 to $400 by now. But yeah. He got this at the Collectors Expo, and he got it for a really good price. And he said, man, here's, And also, we were kind of going through with one of the vendors, and I pulled out this book, and I was thinking, man, this is the one book that I really wanted to get because I got the figurine of it. And he goes, man, put it back. I got you, bro. And soon as we finished, they closed at 9, dropped him off at home. He comes back down, and he got me Deadpool Merc with a Malt number 7. The first appearance of Lady Deadpool. So, brother, thank you so much. I do appreciate that. This will be treasured forever, man. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So, yeah, what a act of kindness, man. Man, awesome act of kindness. I really wanted that Deadpool. Thank you. All right, so next stack of books I'm going to be showing you is the new books that has been released this week. And it's not much, but still there's a bundle. First is Electra number 1. Just love this cover. Kind of have that Adam Hughes-ish type, but I don't really know who done this. Let me know, man, if you know the artist for this, but it's really cool. Love this cover. Second is The Old Guard. Everybody's been hyping about this book. It's about immortal mercenaries. You know, it's like an A-team that cannot die. They go get hired for killing people, and I don't know. RAOK has been doing such a phenomenal job with, you know, Wonder Woman. And, you know, Blackpool has been hyping this up as well about, you know, RAOK. So we'll see what happens. If you see here, the old car, if you ever see that in a gold lettering, go get it because that's one per variant, one per retail variant. That's going for at least about $25 to $30 now on eBay. All right, so the few number 2, has been a very good read. Let's see what issue 2 has to offer. So got that. Everything from here is all eye candies. This is the Joe Jusco variant of Spider-Man. Love that yellow background. Captain Marvel number 2, just phenomenal. Anything with Mark Captain Marvel, I'm gonna try to pick it up with the hype that, you know, her movie is gonna be coming out in 2020. And of course, Spider-Gwen, that pink, man, gorgeous, gorgeous cover. All right, talking about gorgeous cover, this is Wonder Woman number 17. Variant cover done by Jenny Friesen. Anything to do with Jenny Friesen, she has been doing some phenomenal job with Wonder Woman. So I was able to get that out there and about get 2 covers for this. And also, if you're not reading Southern Nightgown, this, if you are into women's boobs and beautiful art, this is it. All mashed into one. Decent story, awesome art, awesome boobs, you know, about chicks with boobs. The cover and the interior art is done by Dawn Mattei. I mean, man, I think she's very underrated when it comes to her art, but I would definitely recommend this. I think the number 1 for Southern Nightgown is done by J. Scott Campbell, and everything from then is all done by Dawn Mattei. So yeah, I highly recommend it. All right, so this bunch of books that I'm gonna be showing you is going to be a backhaul that I was able to attain at one of the LCS. Which is Spawn number 270. I've been starting to respawn again, and there is this new villain, new character that Todd McFarlane has introduced, and the cover art is just phenomenal. I was able to get that in 2 copies. And of course, the Clones Conspiracy number 2, covers done by Delotto, Gabriel Delotto. If you don't know him, man, he's just killing it. And just, I mean, for you to be able to pick up his art for cover price, to me, go grab it. Because one, it is a piece of art that you're getting. He does a phenomenal job with his, you know, oil painting, and that blue is, I don't know, man, just something about it is just it's awesome. It's pretty awesome. Yep. Okay. So I got two copies of that as well too. Beautiful cover, man. All right, Adam Hughes. What can you say about Adam Hughes? Man, he knows how to draw, man. All right. So enough said about Adam Hughes. Batgirl number 2. Batgirl number 4. And Batgirl number 5. This is the one that Doom143 has showed you the inside content of the book. The first page you open, there is Batgirl upside down, spread her legs, bean shot, baby, bean shot. And thank you so much, Doom, for showing me that thing. I tend to like this book more now because of that content inside. So mahalo, bro. Mahalo. Thank you very much. And also, I was able to find the totally awesome Hulk. This issue has like a first all-Asian superhero team called themselves the Defenders. You know, you got Shin-Chi, Silk, Kamala Khan, and Amadeus Cho as the Hulk. This issue is kind of, they're kind of talking about, you know, what they should call themselves. And on the next issue, on issue 16, they call themselves the Defenders. So I haven't gotten the 16, but I was able to find two copies of this. And the cover is amazing, guys. This new Korean artist is up and coming. He has done some covers for, what was that? Secret Wars, and I forgot what variants that, Freddy562 was mentioning, but he did a phenomenal job on this. So if you, his name is Jesus Christ, I'm Korean myself, I can't even say his name anymore. But yeah, check it out, man. All right, this next bunch of books that I'm going to be showing you is all $1 to $2 bin buy, okay? All right. I'm all about David Mack, David Finch, David. Anything with David, I should go get it, all right? But anyway, this is David Mack. He does a phenomenal job with his water paint, watercolor paint, man, but he just killed it with this, got it. As soon as I saw it, it's no brainer. I had to go pick it up. Also, David Finch, he did it with this New Avenger number 4. It's just a beautiful cover. Also, Frank Cho with the New Avengers number 14. Such a great cover. They had two, so I grabbed two of them. Once again, David Finch. Brightest Day number 10. It's a beautiful, beautiful book, man. You got who you got here? You got Dead Man, and I think this is Wonder Boy. So I was very happy to get that. And also they had a incentive variant. I believe this is 1 out of 10, or it could be 1 out of 25. But yeah, they found it in a $2 book. Also, Bloodshot number 1. With the Valiant movies of Bloodshot should be coming up. We don't know if it's going to be Harbinger or Bloodshot, but I believe it's the Bloodshot movies that should be coming out in 2020. So really, really excited to see. So got this for $2, why not? And also, I was very happy to see Justice League of America number 1, cover done by Michael Turner, found this in a $2 bin. All right, so next bunch of books is Mail Call. This is Double Impact number 3, Virgin cover, signed and individually numbered with a certificate of authenticity. This is signed by Ricky Colalero, with his silver, and individually numbered at the bottom. This cover is, man, just eye candy. So I was able to get two of that. The seller on eBay really, really worked with me. So I was very happy to get that. And also, Amazing Spider-Man number 529, with the Spider-Man Homecoming movie with, Tony Stark being an appearance, having such a huge influence in Spider-Man in that movie. To me, it's a beautiful cover. This is the first appearance of Iron Spider suit, and maybe in a second moving of that, Homecoming. Could be they might show some iron suit in that movie, so grab it, man, grab it. All right, this last two book is more my redemption. I remember on my last haul, I told you I got the Avenging Spider-Man number 9. Came home later to find out there is a three inch gash, or not gash, a razor slice that going through that Spider-Man. So ever since then, I kind of lost sleep thinking I have to replace it sometime soon. And I came across this buyer that was really, really willing to work with me. So got this Avenging Spider-Man number 9. And that's right, Avenging Spider number 10 and Avenging Spider-Man number 9. This is when Carol Danvers, Miss Marvel, turns into Captain Marvel. All right. So, the condition in this is probably very fine to very fine plus. I don't know. Could be near mint minus, but I wouldn't say that. But very got this, guys. I got these two books for $25. On a very fine minus to very fine plus condition, I think that's a pretty good deal. All right, we're coming to the nitty-gritty. So these books, man, I got these books at the Collectors Expo that has happened, which I met with Doom143. So I'm just gonna go through very quickly as possible. I got Marvel Comics Presents Wolverine versus the Incredible Hulk. Love that classic cover. And I told you guys about David Finch, the things that he has done with Wonder Woman. This is Wonder Woman number 36. And also Adam Hughes, once again, this is the Batgirl number 1. This is a second printing. Also find myself a very minty cover, condition of Descender number 1. And also was able to find Tales of the Titans, one of the four. This has the Cyborg origin, so I was very happy to find that as well. I'm not done yet, guys. This is something that Doom143 had found in this one box. He threw it at me. I said, why not? Grab it, made a deal. This is a reader's copy, but still got a really good deal on it. This is Red Sonja number 1. Talking about number 1, also got the Punisher. I believe this is the volume 2 of the Punisher. Very classic cover. I was very fine, happy to find this in a very near mint minus condition. And also New Mutants number 18, first appearance of Warlock, and also the Demon Bear. All right, talk about New Mutants. Was able to find a very, very high grade of New Mutants number 1. All right, and also was able to find X Factors number 5. This is has the cameo on the last panel of this page. There's Apocalypse, so I was very happy to find that. And also Batman number 457, first appearance of Tim Drake's, and later becomes a Robin. And this is the one that Doom143 threw at me and said, you gotta get this, which is Justice League number 1, second printing of Jim Lee. And this, I heard that this is a pretty hard cover to find. And so he had two, so I grabbed one. And as you know, who got the other one? Take a guess. All right, I won't tell you who. All right, as also I was able to find Strange Tale featuring Warlock number 180. Strange Tale Marvel Comic Group. I don't know. Strange Tales number 180. First appearance of Gamora. Talking about Gamora, oh my god, this book that I'm gonna show you about Gamora, oh my god, my god. Also, I was able to pick up New Mutants number 14, first appearance of Magic, alright? Now, the last two books that I'm gonna show you guys is the ultimate books that I'm gonna show you in this haul. Of course, I have to show it towards the end, right? All right, so hold on to your guys' seat, okay? Hold on to your seat. Are you guys ready? Bam! All right, that's right. Gamora number 2. This is Francesco Martina, variant 1 out of 25. I was really lucky to find this, to have a buyer willing to work with me on a good price. This is, guys, man, this is near mint, man, near mint. I mean, if I just grade this now, I can swear to God this will come in a 9.4 to 9.6. Maybe with cleaning and pressing, maybe could be 9.8. But this is minty, man, and I got it such a good price. Man, oh man, I'm so happy. So how's this? He got this as a price for $90. All right, $90. He had this price for $15. So altogether, these two books, I got it for $80, guys. $80. So in other words, I got this for free, guys. This right now in this condition on eBay is selling it for $90. All right, so I was very happy to get this. Did I pay too much? I really don't think so. The potential that this, the growth that this book has with such a very minimum print of 1 out of 25, I'm just gonna probably send it to CGC and kind of get it graded, but I don't know yet. But this is beautiful book. All right, so last, are you guys ready? Are you guys ready for this? All right, boom. All right, this is Prince Namor, the Submariner number 1. This is the origin retold again. If you guys watched our our live podcast last week Saturday, we talked about how this, you know, Submariner, the movie is in production. It's gonna be filmed in Hawaii. I've been telling you guys to go grab it because the price is gonna be just jumping. Guess what, man? As soon as that thing was done, I was able to find a buyer that was willing to work with me on a CGC 7.0. And guess what, man? As soon as that news broke, this book is going up in price as well. All right. And one plug at towards the end that I was gonna tell you I was gonna do is, if you have not watched our live podcast, go check it out, man. I will provide you the link to that video. If not, go check out Alex the Comic Holder, that video, that podcast, recorded podcast show is in his channel. Check it out. I was very, honored to be in one of their panel guests. You had the Doom143, Freddy562, Master X Splinter, and of course, Alex the Comic Holder. And you got little old me talking about comic. You know, just five guys talking about variants, you know, specs, the market, you know, just pretty much what you would do when you have five guys in a table just talking about comics, and anything can happen, man. And I think that day, pretty much everything would happen. And if you haven't seen it, go watch it, check it out, and let us know what you think. And hopefully we'll get to do one again sometime in March. But yeah, this is it, man. This is my haul. Like I said, this is one of the longest haul that I have done, plus the biggest haul that I have done. Hopefully I don't want to do this again, because, man, having you guys watch through 25 minutes of this, I apologize, but had to be done. But with that said, this is probably going to be my last haul for the month. And hopefully the next time I see you guys, I will have another key issues, or hope not. I don't know. Whatever it goes, man. But thank you so much. Once again, shout out to Cubic, Comic Addict, SPT, KILLERWOOD, and Chase Variant. Alright guys, with that said, thank you very much for sticking through the end. Mahalos, and good night, good morning, aloha, mahalo, brother. See you guys all later. Bye bye.